Coach, do you think that your team played well enough to win and just chalk it up to a bad break that the puck goes off that check skate and runs Zajac to put the game winner in?
Well, these are tight games, and we know that when you play New Jersey, it's going to be like that, and there'll be parts of your game that you're not excited about, the parts that are pretty good. You get into overtime in any game, you play well enough to get to overtime.
Which I guess aren't even power play.
Well, I mean, the opportunities we were given, we'd like to see them generate at least more offense. They've done a real good job in a neutral zone, not allowing an easy entry. Just forces to have more pucks than we would like. At the same time, that's what you get. So you've got to go in and dig those out and win those battles. And we're just not as quick as we need to be on the things that we do. They've done a very good job in the PK.
It seems like as the game went on, especially the last couple of games, you started to generate some speed through the neutral zone and figured out the Devils' forecheck. Do you think that you're getting more offense based off of being able to skate the puck through the zone and maybe not necessarily dump it in every time, but just be able to generate something off that?
Rarely will they give you anything that resembles an odd man rush to the neutral zone. That's just the way they're built, the way they play. A lot of pucks have to get chipped. If you play that game long enough and your forwards keep skating, you're going to get some offensive zone. I thought towards the end of the third period we were able to do that. But it's a grind. It's a grind on their D and it's a grind on our forwards, and that's where we've got to spend more time. Hopefully the series stays long enough that you start to get some benefits.
Their coach was happy to see the push in overtime, which didn't happen in New Jersey when you guys won in overtime. So the flip side of that, what did you see in the overtime session? Were they just taking it more to you, or was there something different about your OT approach this time?
We didn't change anything the way that we wanted to. Both teams will go out there and try to throw as many pucks in that as they possibly can. Certainly didn't get the sense in the overtime that either team had an upper hand. It's probably pretty even to the goal, game winning shift goal. Maybe they feel pressure different than not at home into the overtime. I didn't see a major difference other than that, there we were really going at that point.
Hey, Paul, the effort you got from guys like Eves and LaRose tonight, and thank you for giving that kind of effort to talk about the series.
Well, that's normally the way you see these playoffs go. I mean, it's the guys that grind all year that get rewarded. I think that fairly, those guys had some really good shifts for us. I think they had to use it on the forecheck as well as anybody tonight. And threw a lot of hits down low, and I thought to Ryan Beta and Scotty Walker did as well. They were pretty physical in the offensive zone. And it gives you a chance because it takes some minutes off your top end. I think, going into overtime, Eric, you're going to play 21, and when you consider the number of power plays that Pendle kills in that game, that's not a lot of minutes for them. They were good lines to put on the ice.